CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 5.
Hello children, I'm back, your mathematics teacher Bharati, with chapter 2, shapes and angles. So today we are going to study about some different shapes and angles, and how we can do it on radio, you must be wondering. For shapes and angles, it would be better if there were some visuals, but radio has its limitations. I am only able to teach you through voice. So if you all pay attention to what I am saying and follow my instructions, we'll be able to easily study the shapes and angles. And I know you all are very smart and intelligent. You have read about shapes and angles in your previous classes. Yes. So you are familiar with the shape of square, the shape of a triangle, and you are also familiar with a rectangle, right? These are all closed shapes. And then, can you recall study of angles? What is an angle? An angle is a figure which has two lines, and these two lines are joined together with a common point. The common point with which an angle is joined is called its vertex. And an angle is not a closed figure. Okay. Now all those who are able to remember, they are smiling very brightly. And all those who don't remember, don't worry. It's not difficult. Let's recall. You have studied about triangle, rectangle, square, and you have also studied about angles. Triangle, square, rectangles are nothing but closed shapes. And angles are not closed. An angle is made up of two sides and a point. The point is common to both the sides. And this common point of an angle is called its vertex. Okay. So let's move ahead. Now, can you find few matchsticks in your house? If matchsticks are not available, try finding toothpicks. And yes, be very careful. I just need you to get around 10 matchsticks or 10 toothpicks. Yes. Good. So you have found the matchsticks or the toothpicks. If the matchstick and toothpicks are not available, then you can take out the sticks from your broom. You can take out the sticks from jhadu, right? Cut them into equal pieces and we are ready to do the activity. Okay. I am starting with 3 sticks. I have 3 sticks with me. And let me try making a closed figure with these 3 sticks. I am joining these 2 like inverted V. And I have placed the 3rd matchstick just below my inverted V, touching the other 2 matchsticks. Yes, I have a triangle in front of me. So how many of you were able to make triangles using 3 matchsticks? Good. What? You have made a straight line using matchsticks? Wow, very creative. I appreciate your creativity. But children, we are going to make the closed figures. Okay. And the closed figure which is possible using 3 matchsticks is a triangle. Okay. Now, what I am going to do is, I am taking another stick. So, how many sticks I have now with me? 1, 2, 3, 4. I have 4 sticks with me. You also take out 4 sticks and try making another closed figure using these 4 sticks. Okay. So, what have you made? Okay. With these 4 sticks, I can make two sleeping lines and two standing lines, and joining them together, I get a square. Yes, why it's a square? Why not a rectangle? Who is able to recall? Rectangle also has four sides. A square also has four sides. The difference is, in a square, all the sides are of equal size. Okay? So that is why if my sticks are of the same size, then using four sticks, I get a square, not a rectangle. Okay? Now the fun begins. So far, with three sticks, we were all able to make the triangle. With four sticks, we are all able to make the rectangle. Now I am adding another stick to it. By adding another stick, how many sticks I have? Five sticks. Let's try making a closed figure with these five sticks. Try making it. Yes. Yes, try a little harder. You know this figure that we get by joining five sticks and it's a closed figure. Don't make straight line. This figure is called a pentagon. Why a pentagon? Pent is five and pentagon is a closed figure with five sides. Yes, it's neither a rectangle nor a square. Okay, now let me add another stick to my sticks that I am using. So I have how many sticks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. I have 6 sticks. Now let's try making a closed figure using 6 sticks. You try. I am also trying to make a closed figure. How do I make a closed figure using 6 sticks? Okay. I am using 2 sticks to make an inverted V and I have made another inverted V just beneath it. And the 2 open sides of my inverted V's I am joining with the stick number 5 and the stick number 6. So what do I have? I have this peculiar figure which is not a pentagon because it has 6 sides. But it's beautiful design. What? You haven't made this? Don't worry. You might have made 2 triangles joined together with the single point where your 4 sticks are matching. Yes. Yes, that is also okay. Because you have used all the 6 sticks. No, you haven't made this. You have come up with another different figure. What was that? Oh yes, what you might have made is an inverted V at the top and then a V, wide V at the bottom, and the open sides of the inverted V and the V at the bottom, you have joined it with stick number 5 and stick number 6. And you know, this is what? This is a hexagon. All the 3 closed figures are that I have just described that are possible with 6 matchsticks are hexagon because they have 6 sides. Okay, good. But some of you must be wondering, if I am using 6 sticks, my brother is using 6 sticks, my sister is using 6 sticks, my friend is using 6 sticks, then how come we are all making different shapes? This was not possible with 4 sticks. This wasn't possible with 5 sticks. Then why this is happening here in the 6 sticks? You know, the reason for this is in the measure of the angle. When we make a closed figure using 6 sticks, it is possible that the 2 sticks that I am joining, they make an angle which is different from the angle made by my friend who is joining his two sticks. So if the angle made by sticks is different, then the final shape using six sticks will be different. And you know, if I ask you to make a closed figure using six sticks, but with a condition that all the angles in this closed figure should be same, then what I am doing? I am not giving you freedom to make the angles as per your choice, and I have also restricted the use of number of sticks. So with these two conditions, wherein the number of sticks used by each one is same and the angle made by these sticks is also same, then we all will be able to make the same closed figure, which is a hexagon having same size of angle and six sides. Okay, now in the first case, I didn't give you the condition that each angle should be equal. So we were able to come out with different shapes. So when the angles are different, then despite keeping the number of sticks same, we are able to draw different shapes, different closed shapes, right? Okay, I hope you have understood this fact. Let me just reword it so that we all understand it clearly. If the number of sides are same, but the size of angles are different, then using six sticks, we can make different closed shapes. Okay? But if I am restricting the number of sticks and also giving you the condition that angles of the closed figure that you are making should be equal, then we will arrive at the same shape. Okay? So for each one of us to make the same figure, what are the two conditions? The number of sticks or sides should be same and the measure of angle should also be same. Okay, now few of you might be wondering, how am I going to measure the angles? How I am going to measure the angles? For this, we need a tester. And what do we call this tester? We call this tester an angle tester. And how do I make an angle tester? You know, it's very easy to make an angle tester. But before making an angle tester, see, if you are able to find your geometry box, all those who are able to find their geometry box, you may have an instrument which is just like your compass with which you draw a circle, but it has two pointed ends and it cannot hold a pencil. So it's a little bit like a compass with which you draw circles, but it has two pointed ends. That means it has two sides which can be pulled apart and it can be closed. Okay. You can make your own angle tester using two strips of thin cardboard and joining these two strips together with a needle or a small pin. But be careful, don't staple both the strips together. If you will staple them together, the strips will not be able to move freely. They'll not be able to close or open. Okay? And you have to place this needle only at one end of both the strips. Fine? So now, I hope you are able to make this angle tester. If not, along with me, then don't worry. You can make it after the session and then you can measure your shapes. But the process is, take two strips of thin cardboard, same size, hold both the strips, one on the top, and at one end pierce a needle so that When you pull apart both the strips, they open easily and then you are able to close it. So this is how our angle tester would be made. With this angle tester, if you make a L shape, all of you are familiar with L, na? English alphabet L. So if you open this like an L shape, you have an angle which is 90 degrees. The measure of this angle is 90 degrees. And an angle which measures 90 degrees, we call this angle as right angle. Okay. Now, all those angles which are more than 90 degrees. How do we reach more than 90 degrees? Just pull apart your angle tester little wider. Yes. So, this angle is more than 90 degrees. Your angle tester is opened like an L. It is at a right angle. Now you have your angle tester ready and you are familiar with 90 degree angle, which is also called the right angle. And a 90 degree angle is always like a letter L, English letter L. Now, if I have to open my angle tester for angles more than 90 degree, what do? I simply pull apart the upper side of the angle tester so that the L shape is destroyed and now I have my both the arms of the angle tester opened wider. Okay, so when we have angles more than 90 degree, these angles are called obtuse angles. Okay, now open both the arms of your angle tester in a straight line. When the angle tester, both the arms are lying open in a straight line, we have an angle which is of 180 degree. And 180 degree is 2 times your 90 degrees. 90 degree plus 90 degree is 180 degrees. Now suddenly why I am started saying degrees along with my numbers? Because angles are measured in degrees. Okay. So when I have opened my angle tester at L, the measure of the angle was 90 degree. When it is opened flat in a straight line, the measure of the angle is 180 degree. And all the angles which are above 90 degree, they are called obtuse angle. And I've just now told you that 90 degree angle is also known as right angle. Okay. Now, few of you I know must be wondering, what if my angle is less than 90 degree? Do we have a name for this angle? Yes, children, we do have name for these angles. If your angle tester is opened in less than L, then the measure of the angles would be less than 90 degree, and all those angles whose measure is less than 90 degree are known as acute angles. Okay, so the two terms that I'm using again and again is acute angle and obtuse angle. Acute angles, the measure is less than 90 degrees, and obtuse angle, the measure is more than 90 degree. Okay, now look around you. Yes, wherever you are sitting or listening to this program, just look around you and see, can you find some angles in your surroundings? Oh yes. The edges of your radio, the speaker, good. The edges of your notebook, textbook, measure the angles. Oh yes, it's like an L shape. So the measure of this angle would be 90 degree. Yes, children, this is a right angle. Okay. Similarly, the corners of your room or your roof, they are also making an L. So that is also a right angle. Okay. Now, can you make an acute angle using your arm? Yes. How can you make it? Keep your hand more towards your shoulder and you have made an acute angle. And if you are keeping your arm straight at the shoulder length, what angle your arm is making with your shoulder? It's 180 degree. Yes? And now try making 90 degree. Wow, very good. And if I'll ask you to keep your arm like this, within few seconds you'll feel tired and you'll say, ma'am, don't punish us. No, I'm not punishing you. I'm simply trying to give you an idea of acute angles and obtuse angles. Okay, so relax. And you can make angles with the help of your fingers also. Try making an obtuse angle using two fingers. Difficult? Just try making it. Stretch your fingers. Yes, you can't make an obtuse angle using your two fingers. But can you make a right angle using your hand? Yes. When you join all the four fingers together and your thumb is alone pointing in a different direction, then you can see you are making a kind of L. And this is your right angle. Okay. Similarly, have you seen a bird with beaks open? Yes. So when the bird's beak is open, the angle is acute or obtuse? It is an acute angle. Similarly, when you open your mouth for eating food, you are also making an angle. Now next time try measuring that angle using your own homemade angle tester, whether you are able to make right angle with your mouth or not. Okay. Now coming back to the closed figures that we have made using sticks. So your angle tester is ready now. You have made some fun. You have had some fun with angles. So let us try measuring the angles using our angle tester and see whether we have made obtuse angles or acute angles in our closed figure. All those who have the books, please open page number 18. Here on the page number 18, we have a picture of a pentagon. Remember, a pentagon is a closed figure with five sides and it also has five angles. Now, if you will measure the angle of a pentagon, you will find that they are all are not equal angles. Okay? And this is what the exercise on your page number 18 in the textbook is asking about. So be ready with your angle tester and try measuring the pentagon given in the picture on page 18 of your textbook. All those who doesn't have your textbooks ready with you, don't worry about it. Just make a pentagon with the sticks that you already have been practicing with and measure angles made in this pentagon. Okay, that you have made with your sticks. And see, how many angles in this pentagon are acute angles? How many are obtuse angle? And do we have a right angle in this pentagon? Just try doing this. Okay? And to add fun to it, what else we can do is, we can make all the angles which are acute, we can color them green. And we can color all our obtuse angles with blue color. So that will add more color to your mathematics. Okay. Now, once you have done with the pentagon, next, let's try again making a hexagon using six matchsticks or six sticks. A hexagon is the name given to a closed figure which has six sides, and we have seen it just a little while ago. If I am using six sticks and I am not given the condition that all the angles should be equal, then my figure would be different from your figure, and the figure made by your friend might be different from my figure and your figure also. So let's make different figures using six matchsticks and try measuring the angles made in this closed figure having six sides. And once again, if you like, you can color all the acute angles with green and all the obtuse angles with blue color. Children, have fun with your angle tester and try to find many angles as possible in your surrounding. Okay, so your angle tester is a very useful device. Fine, and you must be proud of it. Okay, now let us add two more sticks and try to make a closed figure using eight matchsticks. And you know, you have to follow both the conditions and you have to make figures using eight matchsticks. The first condition is where no restriction on angles. If you want to make it with obtuse angle, make it with obtuse angle. If you want to make the figure with right angle, make it with right angle. And if you want to make this eight-sided closed figure with acute angle, just make it. But don't forget to test the angles with your angle tester. Try it. All those who have done it, very good. All those who are still struggling to do it, you can continue after the session also. And you know, now the second condition. You have to make a closed figure using eight matchsticks or eight sticks. But now the condition is all the angles should be equal. Try making it and have fun. And I want to give you another fun activity. You remember reading about fishes in your first chapter, fish tales? Yes, your smiles are telling me, yes, you remember. And you know, in that chapter, we discussed about making the shape of fish using square and triangles. Try making a fish using eight matchsticks. Try making it and you'll have fun. And again, since in this chapter we are learning about angles and we have just made an angle tester, don't forget to measure the angles of the fish that you have made. And fish have fins also. So you'll have to make fins also. Okay? Now, you know that if we use three-sided closed figure, that is called a triangle. If we have four-sided closed figure, that is called a square, or it may be a rectangle also, and it may be a rhombus also. Okay, and if we have five-sided closed figure, we call it pentagon. And if we have six-sided closed figure, we call it hexagon. And if we have seven-sided closed figure, we call it, yes, heptagon. Okay. And if we have eight-sided closed figure, yes, which fish is coming to your mind? Octopus? Yes, octopus has eight legs. We read it in the first chapter and I told you that a fish with eight legs is called octopus. So now I have a figure with eight sides and it is called octagon. Okay, children, keep experimenting with matchsticks, closed figure, and don't forget to use your angle tester. You will find you all, including me and everybody else, we all are surrounded with angles and closed figure. Okay, have fun, stay safe till we meet again. Thank you.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.